you've got an imaginary bucket on your head, and when people do something very kind to you, it fills your bucket. But bucket dipping means they're doing something not very nice. They're pulling your happiness out of your bucket.
This year is my third year working with the school, Perth College being one of those pioneers. Now that I'm sitting here today and, you know, just wow, this is amazing. I wish my children went to a school that had a classroom that was set up like this.
What I'm finding as a parent, I see that this is actually expanding her thinking. I guess the most striking thing out of this whole process that I've noticed in our family is that she understands that she has options.
For me, it's about equipping young people with mindsets and skills that will help them with anything that faces them in their future.
Growth mindset means I can do this, and I'm going to set goals for myself to do this.
So one of the main character strengths was for me, which was zest, which was like participating in groups and being able to speak out and also like have fun while you're doing all of that. Every student should be able to participate and be able to learn about all of their values and strengths, but also being able to, rather than ignoring their weaknesses, should be able to lift them up and make them become their strengths as well, so everyone should be able to access them.
Positive psychology is formally defined as the study of optimal human functioning, but really it is the science of well-being, or the science of us at our best, if you like. And then in terms of positive education, it's taking that science and applying it into the education sector.
You have to just trust yourself that you can do it and give it a try and keep trying your best. And it doesn't matter if you make a mistake, you learn from your mistakes, then you get less and less and less of that, of the scaredness.